morning. Welcome to Fight the Good Fight Ministries. So I am so excited. Today is our first opening, which is January 2nd, 2022. So I am excited to be here this morning. I'm excited that the Lord gave us another opportunity to start all over again. Amen. I'm excited. I have a few announcements I'd like to make, and then I will have Pastor Vic come on up. So the first announcement I would like to make is Monday morning. We have the Monday morning live show with Pastor Vic and Pastor Shannon. That will be at 10 o'clock. Amen? Okay. We also have Thursday morning at 10 o'clock. We have Coffee with Jesus. Amen to that as well. And I know we have a few things upcoming for this new year. I know that we are going on a trip. We will be filming on location in Reno as well as Lake Tahoe. So we'll definitely keep you posted on that as well. And I also want to tell all of you, thank you for your one-time love offering, sowing seed. If you are here this morning and you need an envelope, we have envelopes in the back. Also, we have Venmo on our website, which is Fight the Good Fight Ministries, Las Vegas. There is a Venmo account there. You just click on Venmo and go through the prompts. It's really simple. So we want to say thank all of you. Thank all of you for sowing into the ministry. That is what supplies us, actually, this building, along with everything else that we are able to do in the ministry. Thank you for that. So I'm going to go ahead and get started and open up in prayer, and then I will invite Pastor Vic up. Amen? So let's all bow our heads. Heavenly Father, we just come before you this morning, my God, and we honor you. We worship you, my God. We thank you for today, another day of life. We thank you. We thank you, Father God, for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for this opportunity, my God. We thank you for the ministry, Lord. And we just lift up your holy name, my God, as we were singing this morning, Lord. You are the one that delivered us. You healed us. You freed us, my God, and we thank you, Lord. So in Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. Hallelujah. So let me go ahead and have Pastor Vic come on up, and I am excited. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Pastor Shannon. Those of you that are viewing from live on Facebook, we thank you for following along with us. Those that are showing up, hey, Ruth and my family, thank you guys for being here. We are so blessed and honored to have this opportunity, not just to get Fight the Good Fight, but just back on track again, to have a building that we can come and gather and be together and worship the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
It's so exciting. This is a new year, a new season. And guess what, guys? We got to do something new in this season.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
We got to do something different. We got to train ourselves into fighting bold, if you will, as Christians and believers. Amen? And followers of Christ. So the title of my message this morning, before we jump into it, the title of the message is exactly that. We need to do something different in our training.
Yes.
We need to do something different in our training.
Yes. Amen.
You know, coming from the boxing background, we have to do something to prepare ourselves differently for each opponent, because not everybody's the same. We know that, right? We know that as we go through life. Everybody's different.
Yes.
You know, Tucker's different. Babe Ruth is different. Pastor Shannon's different. Everybody's different. I'm different.
Yes.
That's what makes the world so great. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Because if we were all the same, how boring would that be?
Yes.
That would be boring. Amen.
Yes.
So watch this. As we train ourselves in the boxing world, we had the privilege of watching fights last night.
Yes.
It was all heavyweight card. But all the fighters were different. Okay, and the thing about training is you prepare for a certain fighter, you prepare for a certain style. Okay, now there were a couple guys that had last minute replacements. Pastor Nick, what does this have to do with ministry? What does it have to do with God? I'm going to get into all that, but I want to set the stage for this, because the Bible actually speaks on training and preparation in different areas of the Bible. We're going to get into those scriptures, okay? We need to prepare ourselves for who we're going to face, which entails this. You need to know who you are as a fighter. You need to know the work you put in. You need to know the miles you put in on the track. You need to know the rounds you put in on sparring. You need to know the time you put on the heavy bag, the jump rope, you know, focus machine. Boxing isn't just, oh, I'm going to go in there and make a paycheck. No, you got to train. You got to prepare yourself for the fight. Amen? So as we go through this walk with Christ and becoming a relationship with Christ and becoming a follower of Christ, not just a believer, but a follower of Christ, okay, we've got to do some things ourselves. And that starts with this. It starts with being in the Word of God on a daily basis. It starts with being on your knees in prayer on a daily basis, asking God to guide your way, to guide your steps, to lead you where He wants you to go, not where you want to go. Amen? Because there's a lot of times, trust me, even as a pastor, there's a lot of times, I want to go here, I want to do this, I want to see this person, and the Lord says, no. No. It's the same thing in the gym. There's times that when I was training, I wanted to do what Vic wanted to do. I wanted to do train how I wanted to train. And guess what? My trainer and my dad would say, no. So I learned some things through that. So now as a trainer, when I'm in Carson City and I'm training the fighters, I do surprise, like a surprise quiz, if you will, on them. I will change the routine up on purpose.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. Amen. How many times do we know that in our walk with Christ, when we think that God, we're going to do this, right, God changes it up on us. Yes. God does something different, you know? You have to be, flexible. You have to be easygoing in this ministry to ride this ride, you know? My wife and I watched a show a while back about canoers, people that got in the canoes.
Yes.
And they did this white water rafting in the canoes, you know? And I was amazed. I was like, man, I have respect for water. I used to surf when I was younger, believe it or not, in California. And that's where I learned my respect for water.
Yes.
I almost died. I almost drowned because I wiped out. And I had an older guy, a surfer guy. He told me, listen, you got potential to do this, but you don't have respect for the water. You got to understand how powerful the water. This is where I learned a lesson. Because this guy was the Tony Hawk of surfing that I thought back then. You know, this guy was great on the wave. This guy would ride two. I was like, man. So he said, you know how I did this? Because I respect that water. So you got to understand something. Water moves as one unit. Water will kill you in a minute. It'll break your body in half.
Right.
It's so powerful.
Right.
He says, you got to train yourself. See? Everything we do in life, it's a training method. We've got to have a training mind to get through our walk with Christ. Amen? We're going to start off. Let's go to 1 Timothy. And I'm going to have Pastor Shannon help me read along because we've got some things that we're going to go through on here. Let's go to 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8.
Okay. It says
7 and 8. I'm sorry. 7 and 8. Go ahead.
7 and 8?
Yes.
Do not waste time arguing over godless ideas and old wives' tales. Instead, train yourself to be godly.
Okay, stop right there for a second.
Okay.
Don't waste time. See, I had an old trainer named Miguel Diaz, okay, when I was boxing. And he set me straight on this, just like that surfer did, okay?
Right.
I came to the gym, I did what I wanted to do, and I was getting it. And he told me just exactly that. Don't waste my time. Don't waste your time. You think you're going to come to this gym and you're going to do what you want to do? Why do you think I'm called coach? Why do you think I'm called trainer?
Yes.
I know who you're gonna fight. See, I made it a practice of my, I never studied films of my opponents from amateurs to the pros. I never watched a film of any of my opponents, right, Pastor Shannon? Never. That was my trainer's job. His job was to come to the gym and tell me, this is how we're gonna train today. See, I had to be flexible. See, I learned to be flexible in training because I had to trust, okay, there's that key word, trust in my trainers to prepare my training methods. Just like we have to trust in God, that God is real, that God sent his son, Jesus Christ, to walk this earth, to die on the cross for us. We trust him, we believe that, okay? So we have to have trust in God that he's gonna steer us the right way. His word says he'll never leave us nor forsake us. He'll never abandon us. But it never says that we won't walk away from him. Now you watch boxing, any sports, football, hockey, players, they get traded. They go from one team to the other team and they get traded all the time. Only a certain few players retire from the team. Very few that they started with. Same thing in boxing. Very few fighters will start the sport and retire with the same trainer that they started with. Now, I was blessed. My father was in my corner the whole time. And I had some great trainers. And Gil Diaz was a great trainer to me. But it was time for me to move to another level. So I went with Randy Shields. But my dad was always with me, was always a coach. See, our Heavenly Father is always going to be with us. See, just because I'm the pastor, because I'm a shepherd. I may not be the right shepherd for you, but God has the right one for you. You can't listen to what I have to say. You gotta listen to what God tells you. I'm just a man. So he says, don't be fooled by all this other stuff that's going on. I'm paraphrasing. Let's pick up verse 8.
Physical training is good. But training for godliness is much better, promising benefits in this life and in the life to come.
All the physical training that we did was good. It's good for our bodies. Healthy, keeps us strong. Okay? And people can argue, well, boxing, oh, you beat your head, punch it. Take the good with the bad. That's all I gotta say, right? But all that, it's good for us to be healthy. But what does it get us at the end of the day? At the end of the day, when the rubber meets the road and they throw that first shovel of dirt on your coffin, your body's rotten,
right,
unless you get cremated.
Right.
Your soul, what does all that training profit you?
Right.
Now, I'm not saying get off your diet, be lazy, stay on the couch and eat french fries and potatoes. I'm not saying that. I'm saying much more than the physical training and the 5 miles you run on the streets, on the treadmill, on all the stair steppers you do, and the weights you lift, above and beyond all that. Spiritual training is more beneficial to you.
Yes.
The knowledge of God's word is more beneficial to you.
Yes.
To learn how to discipline yourself with God's word. For why? For the end result when you leave this earth. We are training for the big times. We are training, we're here on earth preparing for the main event. Amen? The main event, the big fight in the sky. That's what we're training for, to be up there to worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ for all eternity. That's what we're training. As a fighter, our goal was two things. Win an Olympic gold medal and become a world champion. Okay? I didn't achieve either one of those in the boxing world. Just wasn't cut out for me. Now, I had a very good record. I retired 18 and 3 as a pro. So I was very good, but it wasn't cut out for me to have a title shot, as much as we tried.
Right.
Call it what you will, it wasn't, but you know what? And I retired brokenhearted. All the training, all the work, all the effort I did, and all the stuff I did, all the miles I ran and ran and ran and jump rope and all the sparring, concussions and all the brutal fights I had. I enjoyed my life. I had a good career. However, I'm in a different training method now. I'm in a different spot now. I'm training for a different fight.
Yes.
I'm fighting the good fight of faith.
Yes.
To preach and teach the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Because he's the only one that can save anybody.
That's right.
So we train. Spiritual knowledge is better than any knowledge you could get. Spiritual training. Train yourself. Crucify your flesh. We go to the gym, but we work out. I see guys in the gym. I used to do it. My trainer would be, okay, 8 rounds. No, we're going to do 12 rounds. If we're not going to do 12 rounds, I was stubborn that way. I was like, Baruka on Willy Wonka. No,
yes.
I'm going to spar. If I'm going to tell me to spar, I'm going to do at least 12 to 15 rounds every day, right or wrong, Pastor Chad.
Yes.
And I would do that 5 days a week.
Yes.
That was me. That's why I'm punching. But watch this. Here, you've got to train yourself. You've got to crucify your flesh. I had to train in the gym to where I was literally crying because I was so much in pain. I would run and I would vomit because I hated it, but I would train so hard that I would vomit. I would crucify my body,
yes,
to make sure I was in shape to fight.
Yes.
Which is why I was pretty successful. I wouldn't get the big fight because nobody wanted to fight me. Okay. So, but we train. We train our body. We train. Same thing here. We got to crucify ourselves. When you get that phone call from your girlfriends, when you get that phone call from the homeboys or the buddies or the guys at work on Friday, hey, let's go to a bar, have a beer. Hey, it sounds good, but you know what? Does God want you to do that? We just had a New Year's celebration, New Year's Eve. All the relatives I talked to, like, Pastor, what are you going to do, bro? You're going to go out? You're going to go to Strip? I said, man, I've been here 20-something years in Vegas, and I don't go to the Strip for New Year's Eve.
Right.
It's bad news.
Yes.
Nothing down there for me. See, years ago, it used to be crucified night. Oh, man, I want to go to a party. That's when I was in debauchery. I used to drink, and I used to drug, and womanize. All that stuff was in the past. But it's crucified your flesh to get to where you're at today to say, oh, I'm going to stay home with my wife and kids, you know, have some smokies and little hot dog things, my wife puts in the pot, you know.
Yes.
Have dinner, watch Dick Clark live on TV, watch some movies, play some board games.
See?
Just like training. We put all the work in. See, to me, the fight wasn't hard. The training was hard, but it was what killed me all the time. My biggest battle was the scale.
Yes.
I hated weigh-ins. I hated weigh-ins. Oh man, I dreaded weigh-ins. I would get sick on the morning of the weigh-ins and throw up just thinking about the weigh-ins. See, it's just a mental thing. I just hated it. I fought the scale my whole life. I was a little fat, chubby kid growing up. Football, I had to do the scale. My baseball coach, because my dad made me get on a scale before a baseball game. I don't know why I had to get. Fernando Valenzuela wasn't skinny. He was a great pitcher.
Right.
But all the time, there was always a scale. I hate scales. And now we have a scale in the house again. But I hate weigh-ins. I would get nauseated the morning of the weigh-in. That's probably why I made weight, because I throw it before I weighed in.
Yes.
But I hated it.
Yes.
It was crucifying to me. But every day, even as pastors, there's things that we want to do and we know we shouldn't do. Come on, let's be real. I'm not a fake pastor. I'm not going to tell you, oh, I'm perfect. I know. We make mistakes. But there's things that we want to do that we know we shouldn't do it. And we got to fight ourselves to pull away from that. You know, I say that and I think about my dear friend, my brother in the Lord, Pastor Charles. Man, he went to Hawaii. He's waiting to come back. He had a rough go up there. We've been praying for him. My dear friends had a rough time.
Yes.
He's going through
yes.
it.
Yes, he is.
But we do. We go through it at times. It's rough, but we go through it.
That's right.
We got to crucify ourselves.
Yes.
We got to prepare. We got to train ourselves daily. Every day, I used to get up at 5 in the morning, 4 o'clock sometime, and run 5 miles 6 days a week. Yeah, I did. I don't do that now, but I did.
Right. Yes.
I was sparring, like I said, 12 to 15 rounds, 5 days a week. I was always in shape. I was in the gym twice a day,
yes.
3 hours each time.
Yes.
That's work.
Yes. Yes.
And some of you guys are like, yeah, I do the same thing. I go, I hit the weight. You see this guy talking. Big
yes.
guys, big muscles, big as my head. How many hours do we spend with God?
Right.
See? Yeah. How many hours do we spend? Well, Pastor Vic, I got a job. I understand.
Yes.
Well, Pastor Vic, I got a job. I got a family. You know, I got to go home. I got to do this. I got to do that. But you know what? It says, newsflash. If you got up in the morning and you started with God, power out is, no, we got to fight. Situation. I think nobody's not enough moving around or something. That's okay. Bear with us. Hopefully it's not interfering the camera there. But listen. Yeah, we just got to have motion. That's what it is. So, new facility. We're working out the kinks. Please bear with us. We love you guys. So thank you guys. But see, it's a test. Now, 10 years ago, 15 years ago,
right.
That would have drove me crazy. I would have got upset. Right, Pastor Chad? I'll be honest. But through prayer, through training, through reading the Word,
yes,
through consulting to God, and you learn to control these things.
Right.
Okay, it is what it is. You can't do something to change the outcome of something that's out of your control. I hope that sounded right. I think you get what I'm saying.
Right.
If it's out of your hands, you can't change it, so why be upset about it? It's like sports.
Right.
You know, you watch a football team, I'm a Cowboy fan. If they don't win, I get upset. But I have to let it go because you know why? I can't change the outcome. I'm not the coach, I'm not a player.
Right.
I'm just a fan.
Right.
Don't let it ruin your day.
That's right. Amen.
You know? Sometimes it ruins about 5 minutes of my day. I'll be honest with you. I'm a diehard Cowboy fan. Golden Knight fan, man, when they lose, I get upset because I'm not a hockey player. I never played hockey, but I like it now. But if I go to Nice and Lewis, man, I get upset. I'm like, come on, guys, get your act together.
Yes.
But we can't buy into all this bickering over stuff
Yes. That's
ungodly.
Yes.
You got to physically train yourself
Yes.
for the good stuff. Let's go to 2 Timothy 3, 16 to 17. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 through 17.
Okay.
Hope you guys get something out of this.
This
is good stuff. I'm encouraging myself. Go ahead, Pastor Shannon, read that.
All scripture is inspired by God and is useful to teach us what is true and to make us realize what is wrong in our lives.
All scripture is given from God. It's not given from Pastor Shannon.
Right.
It's not given from Joe Osteen.
Right.
It's not given by T.D. Jakes, Pastor Shannon, or Joyce Meyer. It's given from God.
That's right. Yes.
For what purpose?
To teach us.
To teach us.
Yes.
To train us.
Yes.
See, when you're being taught something, you're
yes.
being trained in something.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen?
We send our young men and women out to the military, and they get trained on how to defend our country. So we have the freedom to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, just like we're doing now.
Yes.
We have to be trained in every aspect of our life.
That's right.
You think a baby comes out of the womb and starts walking? That would be freaky. No, we have to work with the child.
Yes.
We have to get them up. They start crawling. We teach them.
Yes.
We train them. That's why the Bible said, if we train our kids up in the way, Pastor Shannon,
yes.
they won't be apart from it, right?
Right?
So we train them, we teach them, and
yes.
we take them by the head, and we say, come here, little Bobby, come here, miracle, okay, step. We put
yes.
their feet on our feet, and we walk with them like this, right?
Yes.
I've done that. I know you guys have with your parents.
Yes.
We train them.
Yes.
The Word of God, we're teaching. Teaching. Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Okay. Amen. It corrects us when we are wrong and teaches us to do what is right.
That's
God uses it to prepare and equip his people to do every good work.
So, corrections. When I first started fighting, when I was a little fat, looked like a little fat Chinese, Mexican, Filipino lumpia, what I looked like when I was young, and I started fighting, I started as a southpaw.
Yes.
I started as a southpaw. Now, my dad, my old trainer, Frankie Goodman, they fought like Mickey and Rocky. Southpaws ought to be all. I said, no, southpaw weren't really liked in boxing. But they trained me on how to be an orthodox fighter.
Yes.
See? And it was a struggle. It was hard for me. It was hard for me.
Right.
But what helped me make that transition into boxing was the fact that I used to love to dance so much.
Yes.
And because my father, being the proud Hispanic man that he was, said, no, you're not going to be jumping around a little tutu and tights. You're going to be a boxer. So I rebelled a little bit, but I couldn't stop. So
yes.
I went to the gym, and they switched me from being a southpaw to being orthodox. But you know what? It benefited me because the dancing ability that I was taught and trained behind my dad's back, it helped me in the ring.
Yes.
So as I was preparing for fights, and then I knew, oh, wait, you said I'm going to fight a southpaw.
Right.
But you said those were no good. But I remembered how to fight as a southpaw. So guess what? In the middle of the fight, as I'm fighting, right, I'm orthodox and I'm fighting, I'm hitting the guy here, and all of a sudden, in the middle of combat, I switch southpaw, and it throws him off.
Yes.
You train.
Yes.
Sometimes we have to do that with the devil because he's our opponent, amen? He's always coming at us. And when we feel ourselves falling into something, we got to switch something up.
Yes.
We got to switch something up in our walk. We
got to
check ourselves, as they say in the streets, before we wreck ourselves.
Right.
Amen. So how do we do that? By being in the Word. How does a young man keep his way pure? The Bible says,
yes,
by living according to your Word, God.
Yes.
We got to live according to God's Word.
Amen.
God's Word. Not Pastor Nick's Word. Not Joel Olsey's Word.
Yes.
Amen. Not T.D. Jakes' Word. See? Not the therapist that you go pay $500 to an hour to figure out what's going on. Go to God.
Yes.
I had major issues and hangups. Pastor Shannon will tell you one day when she preaches, because she likes to throw me under the bus, and how jealous and angry I used to be. I used to be angry and jealous. But I had to do some real heavy therapy with God.
Yes.
I had to break some walls down. Commercial newsflash, there's a special gift just for you. All that therapy and all that breaking down,
yes,
it took time. God's still working with me.
That's right.
But through all that, God allowed us to release a book that just came out,
yes,
right before the new year,
yes,
31st of December.
Yes.
Yeah, so check it out. It's at Barnes & Noble. It's on
Amazon.
Yeah, go check it out. It's called Victor Ortiz. It's my story. Check it out.
Yes.
Get a copy. It'll change your life. We got to train ourselves, folks.
Yes.
See, I was able to accomplish that by training myself from stinking thinking,
right,
to godly thinking.
Yes.
We got to train ourselves. We got to build ourselves up in the Word of God. Scripture was meant to edify us, to grow us, to prepare us for what's to come. Amen? Not for this, it's to help us get through it, but it prepares us for the main event. That's where I want to be, the main event. We're going to start wrapping things up. I hope you guys are getting excited. I'm getting excited, but I don't want to stop, but that's what happened. I'm excited. We got a building now. We're actually be able to host people. We practice social distancing. You wear your mask. We encourage that. We got hand sanitizers, wear gloves. I don't care if you come dressed like a Martian. Come and worship with us. Worship God. See what we're so excited about. We're not weirdos.
Yes.
We're good people. Trust me. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 9. I hope this is making sense. I hope you guys get stuck with this. I'm
excited. Yes.
1 Corinthians chapter 9. We're going to go 24 to 27. So So let's start reading, Pastor Shannon, and we're going to, just like we've been doing, we're going to break this thing down, amen? Okay, go ahead.
Don't you realize that in a race, everyone runs, but only one person gets the prize? So run to win.
Everyone runs.
Yes.
Everyone runs.
Yes.
On a football field, they call it the gridiron, all the players play. And we saw last week, even some of the players, they fight with each other on the same team.
Yes.
Watch these damn Redskins, you guys are crazy. Everybody plays.
Yes.
But only one team can win. We all heard that old saying in sports, right? Nobody wants to tie because it's like kissing your sister. Oh, if you see my sister, bro, trust me. You don't want to do that. Mm-hmm. We don't want to tie nothing. We want to win, right? We want to go for the victory. We want that gold trophy. We want that gold medal. We want that championship trophy or the belt, you know? Or Golden Knights, man, they can do it this year. What is that called, a Stanley Cup, right?
Yes.
They got a chance to win that. My Cowboys got a chance to become Super Bowl champions again.
Yes. Yes.
We have to run this race.
Yes.
With training.
That's right.
Training.
That's right.
We want to be the first one to cross that line. We want to be the one to walk through the gate when God, Jesus says, well done.
Yes.
Well done.
That's right.
You've completed your race. I don't want to get there and say, I'm sorry. We held church, but
right.
Too late. I don't want to be like Moses and miss the promised land.
Right.
I'm not saying Moses is not in heaven. I'm sure he's in heaven. I'm just saying. You know, all the work he did with the knuckleheads,
yes.
You know. We'll figure.
Yes.
So let's read on.
Okay.
We're going to run the race like we're going to win.
Yes. Verse 25. All athletes are disciplined in their training. They do it to win a prize that will fade away, but we do it for an eternal prize.
We do it for
an
eternal prize. All athletes are disciplined. Are disciplined.
Yes.
I had to be disciplined. I was not born with this sexy body. I had to work on it. Amen? Really? I had to work at it. When I fought, I had to be disciplined. Who wants to get up? Now, I grew up watching Rocky.
He got up, he always make them put the egg in the...
I did the same thing. It's disgusting. Disgusting.
Yes.
But I was disciplined enough to put the hard work in.
Yes.
It's not easy. I challenge any of you that think, oh, I can go to the gym and I can box 15 rounds. You couldn't last two rounds. I'm telling you. It's not easy unless you train yourself for it.
That's right.
You've got to train. I can't go out there and run 5 miles on a track right now.
No.
I'll be lucky to do a mile. I'm 54. I can still run, but I don't. My knees are shot. I'm not making excuses. I'll throw up and I'll probably have a heart attack. But I can't run like I used to.
Right.
But you know what? All the training, all the experience, all the things that I put into.
Yes.
I can go right or wrong, best shot. I can
yes.
go to the gym and I can box for 5 rounds.
That's right.
Any more than that, I'm in trouble. I do it. I test myself all the time at 54. I test myself all the time. Baby Ruth, when I'm up in Carson, I'm in the gym. I spar with these guys all the time. Young kids.
Yes.
And I feel good about myself. But by round 5, I know I got to quit.
Right.
That's using wisdom.
Yes.
The Bible, God says use wisdom.
Yes.
Don't wait to stop. We got to train ourselves.
Yes.
We got to crucify our flesh.
Yes.
We got to push ourselves
yeah.
to the limit.
Yeah.
When you don't want to read, that's when you should read. When you don't want to come to church, that's when you should be in church. When you think, I don't have time to prayer, you don't have to close your eyes and bow your head to pray. You can pray while you're driving. My wife does it from here to Victorville. 3-hour prayer. God's busy. I tell her, God's busy. Let somebody else get in. Let somebody cut in on that dance. You know? You can do this. If I can do it, the guy with dyslexia and ADD growing up, you can do it. Come on.
Yes.
You can do it. Train yourself. Go ahead.
Yes. Verse 26. So I run with purpose in every step. I am not just shadow boxing.
Shadow boxing. Run with purpose. Read with purpose. Pray with purpose.
Yes.
Worship the Lord with purpose. Yes. Don't just put SOS on it and just sing the song. No, have a purpose in what you're doing.
Yes.
See? He said, I don't just shadow box. Shadow box. I do 5 rounds every day like it's just shadow box. Listen to music and just throw punches and move and work. See? You box yourself. You shadow. You're moving all the time. Discipline yourself in the Word of God. Get something out of it. This is a real fight, folks. We're in it for keeps. God loves you. And He's there with you. He's in your corner. He's like Mickey. Said, come on, kid. I didn't hear the bell. Get up.
Okay, man. You know what I'm talking.
Shut up. There's no time in the box. You got to push yourself. You got to hear the voice of God. Man, I'm going to go box today. I'm so excited. Ruth, I'm so excited to take
it.
We have to work hard at what we do.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
God helps those that help themselves. Man, time is flying. We got 3.5 minutes. Let's wrap this up. Let's land this spaceship.
Okay. The last verse, verse 27. I discipline my body like an athlete, training it to do what it should. Otherwise, I fear that after preaching to others, I myself might be disqualified.
See?
Hallelujah.
Come on. That's heavy right there. 26 is I run with a purpose. You should
yes.
do everything like I said. I got so pumped up. I'm not going to get pumped up again. But you should do it. Read the Word of God with a purpose. When I pray in the morning and I say, Lord, show me something in your Word today. Just like I pray for my wife. God, show me something today to make me fall in love with my wife all over again. 25 years this year of marriage. Show me something today
yes.
to make me fall in love with my wife all over again. I don't care, Lord, the way she does her hair. I don't care how she brushed her teeth, how she cooked eggs. Just show me something, God. But when I get ready to get the Word, I say, well, show me your Word today, God. Show me what Pastor Vic, show me what Vic Ortiz needs to do today to change what he did wrong yesterday.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. You got to be real with God.
Yes.
You can't fool him.
Yes.
Do it with a purpose.
Yes.
Discipline my body like an athlete. Train it to do what it should. What it should. Train your mind to think how it should think in the Word of God. See, when your mind thinks with the Word of God, your feet will walk as God. Remember he told Moses, take off your shoes for why? The ground you step on is holy. You should be stepping on holy ground everywhere you go. Why? Because you're holy. We've got to train ourselves, guys. We've got to train ourselves, folks. We have to. We gotta work hard for what we want to achieve.
Yes.
Nothing comes easy. I tell my kids, we're gonna close right now. I tell my kids this. I told Gabe when he was in school, I tell Tucker and Rico now that they're graduating. Work hard at your education. Take advantage of this time. This is the only thing that this society is gonna give you for free. That's an education. But what's more than that? Get educated in God's Word. We need education to get us through the world. But we need this education to get us through life. Difference. Respect your teachers. I say that because we've got a teacher here. I wasn't too nice to my teachers. Be honest. I was a knucklehead. Don't be a knucklehead. Take advantage of the opportunity God's given you. Take advantage. Listen, you thank you guys for joining us this morning. Here at Fight the Good Fight Ministries, I want you to remember something. God loves you, we love you, and there's nothing you can do about it. Have a blessed day in the Lord. Remember, Pastor Shannon said tomorrow, the Monday morning show with Pastor Vicki Shannon. Thursday at 10 o'clock, it's Coffee with Jesus. And hey, don't miss us in Carson City. On the 23rd, we're going to open Fight the Good Fight Ministries, round two up there. We're looking forward to having you guys. God bless you. Have a blessed day in the Lord.